Hey guys, welcome back to another video. So today on my channel, I thought it would be really fun to do a drugstore makeup starter kit. I know going to the drugstore and even like Sephora and Ulta can be really overwhelming. And a lot of times I even go in there and I feel like I don't necessarily know what I want to get. I thought it'd be fun to just do, basically grab all my makeup and just go through all the drugstore products that I use personally and kind of narrow it down to just a starter kit as far as foundations, blush, bronzer, I mean everything for your face at the drugstore, and the top ones to maybe pick out and try for the first time and just get a starter kit together for you guys. So I'm going to go ahead and start jumping into a few products. I have them all on my desk right here in front of me and it's just everywhere, so just bear with me. And we'll go in the order of how you apply makeup on your face, and everything will be from your drugstore. There's a few things from Morphe that are not necessarily from the drugstore, but they're very affordable pricing. It's just a website online, and I'll link that website down below for you guys to find it. So there's a couple things from that site that I consider drugstore, but technically it's not at the drugstore. But everything else you'd be able to find at Walmart, Target, CVS, Rite Aid, Walgreens, things like that. So let's go ahead and get started, and I hope you guys enjoy. First things first, primer. I picked out three that I actually have been enjoying and I've used for quite a long time that I would recommend to you guys trying. This is the Rimmel Stay Matte Primer, and I have oily skin, so some of those products, you know, that I mentioned might not work for you specifically, but I mean, if you're wanting to try them out, I say, why not? It's Rimmel Stay Matte Primer. Let's see if you guys can see it. There we go, it's a little dirty. I really like this stuff. It keeps me matte, and it almost looks like a lotion. It's not super thick. It's not like a silicone base or anything like that, but it's just a white primer. It just looks, to me, it looks like lotion, but I just put it on, and once it rubs into your skin, it does keep your face looking matte. And I usually put it in these areas here because I do tend to have oily spots start to, you know, on my chin and on my cheeks and on my forehead and in the T-zone. But it definitely keeps your face that mattifying feeling with filling in your pores. Another really good one is the Baby Skins from Maybelline. This is the Instant Pore Eraser, another oldie. I remember when these first came out and I bought this. This is more of a silicone based one, and I only use a little bit of this because I feel like sometimes it can just make my face actually end up looking a little bit oilier. It's clear, so you can't really see it, but it does have more of that silicone base feel for your skin. And then the one that I really like is the Loreal Revitalift Miracle Blur. It's a skin smoothing primer. And again, I do put it in these areas right here where I tend to get more oily and I need something to fill in my pores. So that's this one right here. And I bought this at Rite Aid. This one was a little bit more expensive. That's why I have the smaller one. So I'll make sure to link the pricing in for you guys for each product that I do mention. So that's good for primers right there. Also for moisturizer, from the drugstore, I recently purchased this Neutrogena Hydro Boost. And that's it right there. And I do really, really like this product. It's good for oily and I would say dry skin too, but it's just this blue gel. And this one was a little pricier from the drugstore. I believe this one was like $16 or $17, so it is a little pricier, but I think it's well worth it. It's in a big container, so I only use a tiny bit, and I put it in on my face to moisturize. And so far, I've really been liking it, so this is definitely a must-try for moisturizing your face. So then next, we would jump into foundation, and for foundation, there's a ton at the drugstore. A lot that I've tried out, a lot that have worked, a lot that haven't. So I'm going to show you my top ones that I have been using. These are like my ride or die that I constantly change in and out through my summer, winter months. But these are definitely good ones to definitely try at the drugstore. Skin, Maybelline, which does have a pump. That's this right here. This is another good one. This one's a little bit dark for me right now, so I do like to wear it in the summertime, but this stays on all day and it does have an SPF of 15, so that's a good one to try out. This one, the Revlon Colorstay, this is in color 340. I really like this one. This has a pump as well. This one's good for in the summertime or even actually in the winter when you really want a full coverage foundation. This is the one for combination to oily skin, and I definitely feel like this is similar to a high-end, I want to say it's the Lauder Doubleware. It reminds me a lot of that because it's a little bit thicker, but this is a good one to try out if you're wanting a full coverage face. This one I would say would be medium coverage. My two favorite ones that I wear all the time is this matte clean BB cream from Covergirl. Let's see right there. This is in the color 540 medium, and then the L'Oreal Infallible Pro Matte is what I have on my face today, and this is in color golden beige 104. So there's that right there. This is my all-time favorite. I have this on today right now, and I love this stuff. It keeps me matte. I too tend, I don't think I've ever found a foundation that I don't get oily in my T-zone, but this one is pretty good. I would say about 7 hours in, I start to get pretty oily, and then I just use those blotting sheets. But this one is a good one to try out, so I would definitely try those for sure. So I'm just going to move that stuff out of the way. Now, after foundation, we're going to talk about concealer. And for concealers, I think I have three main ones that I love from the drugstore. So this is my Fit Me concealer. This is in color 25 medium. This is like my ride or die. I've been through probably 5 or 6 of these. This is a really light to medium coverage, and I think it's perfect for those everyday looks. I usually put it underneath my eyes, down my bridge of my nose, forehead, and on my chin, and this blends out very nicely. It does crease on me, but like I said, I've never found a, besides my Tarte one, I've never found a concealer that does not crease on me. So that one, and then this one is the Age Rewind by Maybelline. I'm sure you guys have seen this a ton of times. Everyone talks about it. It's got this weird little thing on the top. But this is another one, another good one to try from the drugstore. I really do like this one. You just twist it up and the product comes out on top, and you just kind of draw the stuff on your face. So this is another good one. And this is in the color Neutrogena. The last one I'm going to mention is this Wet n Wild concealer in light to medium beige. I just recently picked this one up and I've been using it quite a bit too. So there's that right there. Again, you saw the video from before. It just has your regular doe foot applicator right there. And this is another good one to try. Now, the only thing with this is the doe foot applicator. I feel like you have to like keep digging your brush in and putting it on. But the product itself is definitely worth it. After, I would say, concealer, we would go in with powder on the face. And when I set my under eye concealer, I usually use my translucent powder by Laura Mercier, but I recently picked up this Wet n Wild contour palette, and I set my under eyes with this shade right here. I don't know if it's going to look right, this one, this yellow one. And I just put that underneath my eyes with my brush, like so, and I just tap it underneath and set where I put the concealer. So that's a really good under eye setting, and that's a really good one to try out. I would definitely suggest trying this out for your under eyes. And then in the contour palette by e.l.f., there's also another shade, this like yellow banana shade, that I've also used underneath my eyes to set my powder with. So after that, I use powder to set the rest of my face, and I have a couple that I want to talk about. This Neutrogena Shine Control Powder is one that I really, really like, and it's just a regular setting powder, and this is good with setting the whole face. And then this e.l.f. one, it's a whiter powder, it's really white, So I use a tiny bit, but I also put that on my face, and this is real, it's an HD powder, and it's really, really good for setting your whole face and keeping you matte throughout the day. So that's definitely one. And honestly, I think this was probably less than $5. So I really, really liked this one. And then the other one that I really like that I use quite a bit is this e.l.f. or excuse me, this Wet n Wild pressed powder in warm beige. And I recently got this once, but I do really like it. And honestly, I think it's very similar to the MAC Skin Mineralizer powder that's like $32. This was less than $5 at the drugstore. So again, this is the pressed powder 824E in warm beige. So that's that one right there. So after powder is done, I would go in with bronzer. And I have a few bronzers that I want to talk about and a few contour palettes that I want to talk about. So the first one that I already showed you is this e.l.f. Contour palette. Now this is just powder. So you've got your two bronzer colors that are really nice and a highlighting color, and then this would be to set your under eyes. These are nice because these actually pop out and you can customize your own palette. So this is definitely something I would highly suggest anyone trying out if they're just getting into makeup. And they also have a cream version of that where it's all cream. So if you're into cream contouring, you could definitely try that out too. I really, really like this product. I only use it a few times, but I am going to try to get more into cream contouring. It's just cream contouring is just not something that I do on an everyday basis. But again, these are less than $10 and they're perfect for traveling too. That's why I really, really like taking these on the road with me. But another really good bronzer that's like my ride or die staple that I think anyone should have in their collection is this NYC Skin Smooth Skin in, I believe this one's in Sunny. So that's the color right there. This is perfect for bronzing your face up. It's not too orange. It's a really nice, you know, perfect shade for either winter or summer months. And you can see I've bought so many of these. This was like my very first bronzer I ever bought when I started getting into makeup. And I know for sure these are only like $3. So that's a perfect buy right there to get started and, you know, with bronzers and stuff like that. So that's definitely one I would highly suggest trying out. And then also in that contour one that I showed you earlier, I did start using this bronzing color too. It is a little bit deeper tone, so if you're fair skin, I don't know if you would like it as much, but they do have another one that's not as dark as this one. This one's in Caramel Toffee, and the other one that they also have is a little bit lighter for lighter skin tones. So this was like $5, and I love this. I'm so glad that I bought it. After contouring or bronzing up your face, the next thing I would go in and do was blush. And I have a few blushes here that I want to talk about. Now, e.l.f. does have a another palette like those ones I was just showing you, but it's just for blush. So this is what it looks like. And again, these little blush things push out, so you could just put your own specific ones that you want in there. But there's what that looks like right here. And they're very, very pigmented. I think they're beautiful colors, but you just want to have a very light hand with these. So these are really good for traveling also. I thought I grabbed my other one, but maybe I just grabbed this one. But there's two. There's a light one and a dark one, so that's a good one to keep. And then for an alternative, you could do the Wet n Wild Color Icons. These are also really inaffordable and cheap. This is Mellow Wine. This is like one of my favorites. I wear this color all the time. It's so pretty. Let's see that right there. And these are less than $5 at the drugstore, and I absolutely love these. This is another color, Pearlescent Pink from the Wet n Wild. And this one has just a little bit more of that shimmery look to it, but it's so pretty in the springtime. These are great blushes to have. Definitely if you're getting into makeup, I would highly suggest trying these out. So after blush, we would go in. I'm not big on eyeshadow, but I am going to mention just a couple. But this one is the NYC Love in Paris You can tell I use this quite a bit. I've hit pan on a couple of them. These are really, really pretty colors for every day. I use this for work mostly. I'll go in with into the crease with this one, and I use this one for a lid shade, or these two for crease colors. It's a really good neutrals palette, so you could wear this on an everyday basis. And that's what it looks like. So that's definitely a good one from the drugstore. And then another one that I don't really consider a drugstore, but it's off the Morphe site. I'm sure you guys have seen this everywhere. This is the 350 palette for Morphe. This one, I don't even know if it's still available on their site. Hopefully it is, but this is another good one to keep as a staple. It was less than $30, and it has so many warm tones. I would highly suggest, if you can get your hands on this, to try this out. They just have beautiful shades, and they're all really pigmented, a bunch of browns. I definitely don't feel like I need any other, palette, because these are just, they're really, really pigmented. I swatch a couple of the shimmery ones here for you guys. They're just so pretty. There's just a few of them right there. But any palette I feel like that you can get your hands on from Morphe, I feel like would be a good palette to try out. So after eyeshadow, I would go into, well, let's talk brows, because I totally forgot to talk about brows in the beginning of this video. So for brows, I have quite a few products that I would suggest trying out at the drugstore. But these two in particular, the Brow Stylist from L'Oreal, their line of all this stuff is so good. This is the pencil and the mascara that I've done a video on my channel. So I'll link that down below on my eyebrow tutorials. But these are two products I would highly suggest trying out if you're just getting into brows. Another one would be if you're getting into pomades. This is the NYX Tame and Frame Pomade. Is another good one to try out. And the Salon Perfect one that I did have in my other video is another good one. And NYX one in brown. You can see mine's pretty messed up. But for a good drugstore one to try for powder would be this one. This is in brunette. This is a really good one to try. And NYC, or why do I keep saying NYC? NYX NYX you can get at Ulta. So if you have an Ulta near you, I would definitely try those ones out. And then for an eyeshadow base, before you do your eyeshadow, there's two in particular that I want to try, well, that I want to mention, is the Milani Eyeshadow Primer. This is really good. I have oily lids, so this is really good to keep your eyeshadow lasting longer. And then this NYX eyeshadow base in, this one is in Skin Tone 03. So that's what it looks like. And I just put that all over my lid before I start doing my eyeshadow. So those are two that I would try out. Would be highlighter that I want to talk about. The two that I'm going to mention are the Wet n Wild Color Iconic in Reserve Your Cabana. This looks like a powder, but it's a very, let's see if I can get it. There we go. This looks like a powder, but it is a very, very subtle highlight on your skin. It's so perfect if you're not somebody that wants something like bam in your face. You can't really see it. It just gives you a very, very subtle highlight, and I love this. It's less than $5, and it's perfect for every day. Another one would be this e.l.f. Golden Bronze palette for another highlighting. It's beautiful, and I just mix this one and this one, and I just put it right here with this brush, and just like you can see that glow right away. It just gives you a very nice subtle highlight. So this is another one, less than $5, that you guys, I'm sure, that would love. So then after that, I'm going to talk about just a couple brushes really quick that I would suggest trying out at the drugstore. For the most part, they're going to be the Wet n Wild brushes. This is just one of them right here. I use this for bronzer or for blush, powder even. And then the Real Techniques brushes that I've tried out. This is for foundation. these are really good to try out. I have a blush brush just for this. I use it for bronzer, but I don't have it sitting right here in front of me. And then the e.l.f., all the dark ones that they have at Target and Walmart. This is like the $3 line, and these are really good. This is the face complexion brush, and I like this for bronzer. And then these two right here I use for foundation. They don't have names on them, which I kind of don't like, but they're for the face. I think it says on the packaging that it's like for, you know, foundations or powders. This is an angled blush brush, and I use it either for bronzer or for blush. And they also have a flat brush, like so, that you can go in for baking down below, or like really chiseling out, or you can do it for chiseling out your cheek area. And then for eyes, I have a couple, the e.l.f. and Wet n Wild brushes. And these you can all find at Walmart and Target. The white ones are the Wet n Wild. These are maybe $2, and this one was maybe $3. And then eyeliner. The only eyeliner that I really like is actually the Ulta brand, the just black Ulta brand, but I don't have it sitting in front of me. And then the other one that I use is this NYX two-sided. It's got the one side here and the other side with the felt tip. The felt tip dried out on me pretty fast, so that was the only thing I didn't really like, but I do love this side with just the eyeliner, and I use that to draw underneath my top line here and then underneath on my bottom. Now I'm going to talk about lashes and mascara and lips, and then we'll be done. So for mascara, my two that I absolutely love that are good for a starter kit would be the Maybelline, they're both from Maybelline, the Last Sensational and Colossal. Those are them right there. And this one's really good with giving you volume. Like, that's how I have on my eyes right now. And I love that it doesn't make them like super clumpy. This one separates your eyelashes a little bit more. I do really, really like it though. And it's got that rubbery wand instead. So it's got a little curve to it as well. Both really good mascaras. Both last a long time. They don't flake or anything like that. So these would be good for a starter kit on mascara. Lashes, I would say, I don't have the Ardell's sitting right in front of me right now, but Ardell, the Demi Wispies, or the Wispies from that Ardell collection, are really, really good ones. They're not super expensive lashes. These two are from Salon Perfect, and the Kiss, this is in the Shy, and this is in the 614. These would be good. These are good for going out, but then they're still good for like every day. That's the Kiss brand. And then these are a little bit more for nights when I'm going out. I'll wear something a little bit more fluffy, I guess, and like in your face. But these are two really good brands. Kiss and Salon Perfect have the best brand, and Ardell have the best brand at the drugstore to try out. So these are two brands that I would highly suggest you guys trying out if you're just getting into lashes. Let's finish up with lips. I'm gonna just mention a couple right here. What I have on my lips right now is this Sandstorm NYX Liquid Suede. I love this color. I just recently bought it, and it is seriously becoming one of my favorites. I have it on right now. I will swatch it for you guys. It's beautiful. They do dry down matte, and it's not uncomfortable to wear. It is very comfortable on the lips. I would highly suggest trying these. They're just a cream liquid lip. So I got this at Ulta. And another really good one is the Liquid Catsuit Mega Last in Give Me Mocha. This is from Wet n Wild. Yeah. And I believe I had this in my first impressions video, but I'll swatch that one. It's very dark compared to the Sandstorm. I'll show you this. So that's Give Me Mocha, and that's Sandstorm. Very, very pretty colors for everyday wear. Soft matte lip cream. I would say Wet n Wild and NYX are the two that are really good for, what's this one? Abu Dhabi. That one's Abu Dhabi right there. Lipsticks. This one is Untainted Spice 950. This is from Maybelline. And Maybelline is another great lipstick brand. Into more of a lipstick and not necessarily liquid lip. Maybelline's lipsticks are 100% my favorite. And they're really easy and comfortable to wear on the lips. So that's this color right here. Can you tell I really like warm colors? They go on easy. They don't feel dry out your, you know, they don't dry out your lips or anything like that. And they're very comfortable to wear. So this is another good one to check out. I think that that's everything I wanted to cover in today's video for a makeup kit. Hopefully that helps you guys out with when you're going into these places. I know it can get very overwhelming, and hopefully my suggestions kind of help. So these staple products right here are good for anyone that's starting out on makeup, anyone that wants to get more into makeup, try new things. All these products are things I would 100% suggest to any of you guys, and hopefully that'll give you a little bit more help on where to get started when you walk into the drugstore, Ulta, places like that. And it'll help you out a little bit better. End video right here. I hope you guys enjoyed everything that we went over. I hope you guys are liking the channel so far. If you guys have any requests for any future videos, please do not be afraid to leave any comments down below. Give me some feedback on how you think I'm doing. Any future requests that you guys want to see. I'm trying to do other videos other than just makeup, but I feel like right now that's really where my passion's at. So I might just be focusing more on makeup as far as that side of it goes. I think I'm gonna end it here. So thank you guys so much for watching, and until next time, I'll see you guys soon. Bye.